That doesn't sound right. That doesn't look right. That doesn't feel right. So with that, let's get out of this cold and talk about how it's affecting your vehicle. And what do all of those have in common? Rubber. And no, we're not talking tires, but everything else in between, from your control arm bushings to your belts to your hoses. Let's take a look at some of those items and show you how you can help your car out this winter. Starting underneath the vehicle, control arm bushings are probably one of the most notorious items to fail and get accentuated in the cold weather, start to make noise, and that can be due to simply the condition of the rubber. If you know that your vehicle is sitting on its original suspension, but doesn't make any noise in the summertime, and you start hearing a little bit of clunking or thumping in the winter, that is due to whatever has started to fail or is failing within the rubber bushing. Taking a look at this rearward control arm, you can see some light cracking in that bushing. In warm weather, it's not gonna be such a big deal. The rubber's gonna be soft and supple. In the cold, however, this rubber is gonna stiffen up, and in extreme temperatures can even harden to a semi-glass-like material, allowing it to tear even easier. So if it's already developing tears or cracks, then the cold is only gonna make that worse, which is why you start to hear all the noises in the cold. Similar to the way that the control arm bushing can fail, you have everything else attached to them that's gonna have the same effect. You have your rubber boots around your ball joint ends, you have the rubber boots around the CV shafts, end links, tie rods, all those can be compromised and the cold can only make it worse. So just be mindful, inspect your vehicle before the season starts, take a look, and just keep in mind that that tiny little tear, that tiny crack, or that tiny bit of leakage coming out of the CV boot or the ball joint is only gonna get worse with the cold. But along with the rubber components hanging out underneath and behind your wheel, let's take a look at some of those items that can be affected underneath the hood. It's the same story. Now you have components that maybe don't necessarily always move like the suspension ones do, but due to heat and then rapid cool down, especially in the winter, they can get brittle. We're looking at our rubber coolant lines, we're looking at the vacuum lines, the belts. The same theory applies. If you have stuff that is original, is over 100,000 miles old and has not been replaced, these all get significantly more delicate once the temperature starts dropping. Coolant hoses, at least the majority of the new ones that are quick connect, if you will, have O-rings in them that over time go flat. Now you have an O-ring that is flat and brittle, that's gonna give cause for a possible potential leak. Change that, maybe you don't have O-rings on your coolant lines, but you have regular clamps. The rubber line itself over the years will start to degrade, and now you throw in a pressurized coolant system and a brittle coolant hose, that's an easy tear right there. So just something to keep in mind that hasn't been serviced on your vehicle before or you haven't really checked it out, take a look at it, check for any leaks. That also applies to your gaskets, like your valve cover gaskets or flange gaskets. If you have a small weep, that can significantly increase in the cold due to the expansion and contraction of those seals. Belts are another critical component that you want to expect. Ever hear your car start up in the morning as it gets colder and the belts are squeaky, but then it goes away? That should be a time to go ahead and inspect that belt system. A small fray or crack in the belt can cause that squeak. Once it warms up, it may go away. So be sure to check that out, as that is something that can leave you stranded on the side of the road, and you don't want to do that as it gets colder out there. Now, while we've covered some of the critical components, both underneath the vehicle and underneath the hood, there's still a few more items to talk about. And not to say that this is everything, but the next most common and important is going to be your windshield wipers. These live outside all year round, so whether you're in the hot summer or in the cold winter, they're constantly being battered by the weather. Now you throw into the mix, again, sun damage, plus the cold stiffening up the rubber. Maybe you left a little bit of ice on the windshield when you went to hit the wipers. All that kind of stuff degrades these wipers. And these are critical to your vision and your safety. These are a simple item to replace and something that you should stay on top of at least twice a year, depending on where you live. Again, while you may not use them all the time, they're strictly aging just from sitting on the car. And of course, we're leaving out a couple components. You have window seals and trim and all that good stuff that keeps the vehicle sealed from the elements. But for today, these are gonna be the main components that are gonna make your winter driving experience a bit better. We hope this video helped that. If you like it, please consider subscribing. If you have any questions or comments on what we covered today, or maybe you have another tip you'd like to add, Leave that in the comment section below, and please consider subscribing. We're making videos like this all the time. As always, thank you so much for watching. We'll catch you on the next one.